Alisha Seem always knew she was destined for a career in technology.
When you're young, you start to gravitate towards certain fields, and math was always my thing. I was the kind of kid who was in math camp from age 7, and then, you know, flight science camp, engineering camp, kind of just went from there.
It brought her to Palo Alto and the AT&T Foundry, where Alisha is on the front line of research in the field of virtual and augmented reality.
We're at a point now where this industry is really on the cusp of hitting mass market adoption, because in the way that sensors have improved, touch technology has improved, display technology has improved, everything's gotten smaller, cheaper, and faster. And I think we're at a point now where we can actually create these immersive, interactive experiences that are deployable to everyday consumers.
More than 2,000 miles away, Jordan Holly had a similar childhood.
I'd say since high school, I've been interested in the computer and science field, because that's kind of when I started to figure out that I'm pretty good at science and math, and I like both of them a lot. And then in college is when I decided to go computer engineering.
What's the most boring part of your job? Jordan just might make that go away one day. She's working on bots. Not those kind of bots. Computer programs that automate the mundane functions that can sometimes drive us a little crazy. Think service orders or metrics reports.
Most of the jobs at AT&T still need people, you know, finding solutions and just making like choices that a robot could never make. And so what we do is we take the things that don't require those manual choices and require those problem-solving skills. You know, we take that stuff, we get it out of your way so you don't have to deal with it. And so now you can focus on the problem-solving and all the other important stuff.
Two cutting-edge technologies that are poised to play big roles in our future. And both Jordan and Alisha are excited about the possibilities.
Obviously, there are massive implications in video entertainment and gaming. But beyond that, I think as the technology becomes more robust, more user-friendly, and the content starts to develop, I think there could be significant implications within fields like healthcare, public safety, education, retail, things like that.
The bot really does help people do their job a lot more efficiently, because now instead of having to take hours and hours to work on these things, they can just have it run by itself, you know, automatically, and then they get the report and they didn't have to do anything.
The other thing Jordan and Alisha have in common, they're women making their mark in the technology world.
At this point, I'm pretty used to being the only female in a predominantly male environment.
But they're both seeing more and more women every year. Alisha says the key is to focus on contributions.
We have a really strong diversity of backgrounds here. We have a really interesting mix of very intelligent people who are all working on different things and had different strengths and lots of different ideas to bring to the equation. And that environment is very inspiring, and it works really well for me.
I think women in STEM and, you know, computer engineering type of careers is very important, just because a lot of people in society don't see women as technical, and it's very good to like break those barriers, make people see that, no, we can do everything equally.
And that's not virtual or augmented. That's just reality.